There are certain things that you learn in life which stay on with you forever. 13 January 2003, the day I became a chartered accountant. I was only 22 and a half years of age and I had completed my CA in the first attempt and with a rank. I, friends, family and relatives were very happy about it. In fact, everybody told me that life is set. I had started planning for a brighter future. A few weeks later, I started getting calls from companies for campus placements. In fact, I had a rank, so I got calls from 7 companies. I was thinking, what if I get selected in all 7 companies? How will I make a choice? Which company to join? I started preparing for these interviews and gave them one by one. Now, after all the interviews were completed and the results were announced, I got the biggest shock of my life. I had not cleared even a single interview. I was very upset and I had no clue of what to do next. One day, I got a call from a lady called Vandana. She was an HR person with one of India's top 10 steel manufacturing companies. She asked me to come down for an interview. I saw some hope. I went to the office well before time and I was waiting for my turn to meet Mr. Chen, the CFO of the organization. I was very nervous, in fact, I was very scared because I had already failed 7 interviews. I met Mr. Chen. He was a gentleman and made me comfortable by sharing his experiences about the organization. The interview started on a positive note. In fact, I thought that this is the company and interview that I was waiting for to start my career in the corporate world. The interview started well, but as it progressed, it became slightly difficult. I remember that I couldn't answer certain questions. In fact, there were certain questions, while answering them, I froze. Somehow, the interview completed and I went back home. I thought to myself, even number 8 is not lucky for me, and maybe I'll have to wait for more. But a week later, I got a call from Vandana again, and this time it was a good news. I had been selected for the role of a finance executive. I went to the company, collected my offer letter, signed a copy and gave it back to Vandana. Now I told Vandana that I had a question which I wanted to ask Mr. Chen. Vandana smiled and said, "It looks like he's free. Come, let's talk." I met Mr. Jain for the second time. I thanked him for giving me the opportunity of working there as a finance executive. I said to him that I had a question which I wanted you to answer. He said, "Please ask." My question was, we both know that the interview was not perfect, but I still have the offer letter. This was easy for Mr. Jain. He explained to me that he can teach me how to work, he can train me on how to do things, but what he could not do for me was give me the right attitude and intent, and he found both these in me. Finally, I thought that somebody had something positive about me as a chartered accountant. Now, what Mr. Jain said stayed with me forever. It's been 17 years I've been working and taking a lot of interviews as well. When I hire candidates, I also scout for the right attitude and intent. With my experience, I've seen people who are high performers in the organization have both these qualities at every point in time. Now, this was my learning that I carried in my career. Thank you for listening to me, and I hope you share some feedback. Thank you and good luck.